All right, 50 years ago, what could have been bigger than man landing on the moon? Well, in the summer of 69, folks in Fort Worth were focused on something else.
Something that couldn't be explained. Here's Bradley Blackburn with the mystery of the Lake Worth monster.
Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour.
That summer of 69, when most eyes worldwide were trained on the heavens, many in Fort Worth kept an eye on the ground.
I mean, people took it seriously.
Because the second biggest story 50 years ago today,
this has drawing from having seen,
was about a monster that called Lake Worth home.
Reports of the Lake Worth monster or creature or
Jerry Taft from the Channel 8 News team on the case.
Or whatever you want to call it. Some who have seen it say it looks like a half man, half goat.
They still look for him at the Fort Worth Nature Center and Refuge.
And people claim that the monster was up there on the ridge.
Where in July that year, there were multiple sightings of a creature with a fearsome description.
Like ape-like creature, goat-like with ram's horns and fishy, scaly.
Weighed about 350 pounds.
Eyewitnesses told WFAA the monster threw heavy tires at a crowd down in this quarry.
And he threw a tar. Some 400 to 500 feet.
It was up there on those cliffs, and it'd stay up there running back and forth.
This young man saw it too, his name Ronnie Armstrong, presumably no relation to that guy on the moon.
It was pretty rugged and had a lot of weeds and trees around it, and I couldn't see how no human could really get through there as fast as it could.
All these decades later, you can find giant hairy beasts here, but we call them bison.
They're proud of their herd of 17 animals who show no evidence of hurling tires. But at Lake Worth, the monster of a story is still very much alive.
This is our heritage here at the Nature Center.
In Fort Worth, I'm Bradley Blackburn.